Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. This is the first video right after the maiden of this little harrier. If you like to see it, here I got a link. And I want to start an extra video series about lightweight PLA printing. Yeah, especially lightweight PLA, lightweight printing. Yeah, because we want to print airplanes. They should be super stable and also super lightweight. And I do this now for several months and figured out that there are a lot of issues that has to be solved, and maybe I can help some of you and we get all together better print results. In this first episode, I want to talk about the hot end and its parts, how it works, how this lightweight PLA works into the hot end, and all the different parts and what is important on the hot end while printing lightweight PLA. And then something special here, why we can't prevent the stringing, yeah, while printing. And we want to start evaluating the print results just by optical observation, by looking at them. Yeah. So I would say just take a closer look on what we see here. This is, for instance, the Creality CR10 Max. This is the biggest printer I use at the moment, and a smaller one. This is the Ender 3 V2. Yeah, they are both great printers I really like to use. And I want to say, let's start. So let's start with the hot end. I think a lot of you know this. We got our Bowden. Yeah, this is a Bowden hot end. This is the Bowden. Here we got inside the lightweight PLA filament. And this is our heatsink. Yeah. Here I got a V5 hot end. This is how it looks like in original. And after the heatsink, there is the heat block with the heating patron and the thermistor. Yeah, and at the end we got our nozzle with a silicone sock. So, and now what is important on this heatsink while working with lightweight PLA? You know, this lightweight PLA is just lightweight because it starts foaming. So the volume expands. Yeah, and this expansion starts when it is getting hot into the heat block in all this area. And something that should not happen is that it starts expanding here in this upper metal rod, because then it can stuck. Yeah, when it expands, because we still work with some retract. Yeah, and when all this gets retract and the printer wants to push it back and it stucks here, there is no movement possible. So it is very important that this heatsink is good cooled. Yeah, so take care that you had a, that you have a good fan, and this air, this fan is mostly free. Yeah, I also freed on my CR10 printer. I freed them complete. Is there, for instance, a too tight grid in front of the fan? Yeah, maybe you can remove it. I did this on my CR10 Max to get much more to the heatsink and to cool it more. That the temperature in this area is that cool that the expansion don't start into the rod inside here and just start into the heat block. Yeah. And the next important thing is that the temperature all over here should be constant. Yeah, this means that the temperature doesn't sink into the nozzle. And for this, you need a heat sock that is going all over the nozzle just to the top. Yeah, some socks already end here in this area. And the best solution I mentioned is when the sock goes as far as possible up to the end, almost at here, we can see on this Creality printer, for instance. Let's come to point three. Yeah, why we can't prevent this stringing? This is because this filament is always expanding. And if it starts expanding, we can't stop it because we can't shut the temperature down immediately. Yeah, just also when we work with the retract and we push this down, this will be cut off here, about here, so this go maybe some millimeter back, but the expansion still goes on and the filament is pressed out. Yeah, so it is not possible to print lightweight PLA without any stringing. But that's no big problem. Yeah, just for you to know, this is something that is how it is. Okay, then let's go to the evaluating of the results. Here I got two very, very different results with the same filament. One is printed with a CR10 Max and one is printed with Anycubing Mega X. The same temperatures, everything the same cure profile. They look very, very different. And we want to talk about why this looks so. Yeah. And when we take a closer look at them, we can see this is very homogeneous on the CR10, while the Anycubic one has a lot of small holes and is different, especially a very different color. Yeah. And my opinion about this is that the temperature in this hot end was not consistent. This means that it was also here quite hot. That's why I removed the fan grid so that the maximum of air can cool all the heatsink. Also some parts that are disturbing the airflow into the printing head I removed so that there can be a good airflow complete through. And also, like I showed you here on these hot ends, I was changing the silicone sock to a complete one, yeah, that mostly covers the whole heat block and nozzle, and the print results get even much, much better. Yeah. But nevertheless, there are big differences in the printing temperature and also in the flow, which are the most valuable adjustments while printing with lightweight PLA. On these Creality printers, the temperature is about 242 degrees and the flow is about 44%. And on other temperature, like the Anycubic Chiron, I print with 210 degrees and about 48%. Yeah, so there are really big differences in the cure settings. So it is not so easy to say there's an average temperature and an average flow, which I can use for all the printers. It's really important to observe the result and understand, is it too hot? Is it too cold? What can I adjust? Yeah. And another very important hint for a too hot temperature is when you got these dark spots in here. Yeah. That means that that the lightweight PLA is completely melted, so that some PLA drops come out here. They disturb very badly the layer construction, yeah, so that nearly a complete layer is missing all over the part. And when you see this, your temperature is definitely too high. Yeah, I want to show you this on some examples here. Here we got a part printed with the Anycubic Chiron, yeah, which was too hot printed, so we got these black spots. This is where the filament was getting much too hot, that it was completely melted far away over the foaming point and just flow out like a drop of a melted PLA. Yeah, and here is the same, not that bad. This was printed with the CR10 Max. Yeah. Also a little bit too hot, so we have also these small big spots and they don't block completely the nozzle, but they disturb the layer. Yeah, and so when you bend your part, it could even break in an area where you got these melted points. Yeah, so don't go too hot, because when you go hotter and hotter, it is not that the foaming material gets more foamed and foamed. There's a climax where you really got the best result, and also not too brittle, because you want to have a stable plane. Yeah, it should not be like rubber, but it should not be brittle that it breaks immediately after the first bending. Yeah, when I break here, you hear it cracking and it immediately breaks. Yeah, this is what happens when you print this lightweight PLA much too hot. Yeah, so this is the very cool part on this material. There are a lot of parameters, material parameters you can affect by just changing the temperature. Yeah, this means especially the volume. When you rise up the temperature, the volume expands, but just to a climax. Yeah, after this, it increases again and gets much brittle, and this is not what you want. So that's why it's very important to figure out the perfect print temperature for your own printer. Yeah, and one last thing that also helps is when you print a test part and you break it, then smell on it. When it smells hardly chemical, you are much too hot. Yeah, it should smell lightly chemical. Yeah, so when you break it, taste it, and this part was too hot and this smells really hard inside because this is all hollow, so the air stays in, yeah, just after days and weeks. Yeah, and you even will smell it even while the printing itself, when you have a small printing room and it starts smelling, you are much too hot with the temperature. Yeah, this won't be any good results, and I think it's even not healthy. So print small parts, start with a low temperature, look at the result, yeah, look closely. I also can recommend you using such a loop with included lights, yeah, with different colors of lights. This helps while observing different print colors, and take a closer look to your print result and see if you have a homogeneous structure. Yeah, this is really, really important to set up your printer before starting these big parts. Yeah. Okay, I would say that's enough for the first part of our lightweight printing tutorial. In the next part, we want to go a step deeper into the Cura profiles. And if you like this channel and what I'm doing here and you want to support us, there are some links underneath, yeah, where you can buy me a coffee or become a Patreon or do a PayPal donation. Yeah, this really helps to go on with this great stuff. Yeah, let's do it. And we want to see you in the next video. Bye bye.